Sheriff, thanks a lot for being here. And before I get into some questions, can you at least tell us why we did ask you if you would stand next to Tag and do a debate? How come you decided not to?
Well, I'm the sheriff, and I believe that I stand on my record, I run on my record, and I don't need to stand here with John Tag beside me to convince the people of Orange County that they voted for the right guy the first time.
All right. You've got a big job, 1 million people in unincorporated Orange County to protect.
Yes.
50 cents of every tax dollar goes into public safety in Orange County. The lion's share of it, more than $180 million a year, goes into your department. What have you done during the past 4 years specifically to keep people safer, and can you be specific about what you would do if given another term?
Well, I've taken the resources that have been provided to me and did the most with it during this period of time. In fact, overall crime in Orange County is down, and it has gone down each year that I've been sheriff so far, and it hopefully will continue to do so because of the experience that I bring to the table. I've taken deputy sheriffs within the agency who were doing administrative jobs. I've put them out on the street to do enforcement, first response duties. There's 30 more deputies doing that today than it was when I started.
So would you say your administrative staff is less than it was under Sheriff Berry before you?
Yeah, that's correct.
I want to talk about specifically a couple of episodes that happened during your first term, one of them back in 2010 in the summer when you had those barbershop raids with the Department of Business and Professional Regulation, and those raids on various barbershops that appeared somewhat SWAT-like. And I want to read something from Congresswoman Corrine Brown. If we can show that on the screen. She said, quote, "These inspections were carried out in a SWAT-like manner. I am aware of allegations of racial profiling and unjustifiable searches. The manner of these raids paints a picture of overkill and perhaps a disregard for due process." In hindsight, were those raids perhaps a poor decision at that time?
Well, first off, you characterized them as raids. They were not raids.
Well, I'm not the only one who characterized them.
Well, I would not characterize them as raids, first off. Mm-hmm. What happened was there were members of the Department of Business and Professional Regulation that reached out to the Orange County Sheriff's Office to assist them in doing their job. Mm-hmm. They felt threatened for their own safety in going in and doing inspections. Members of my agency simply went in with them to do enforcement. They did encounter some individuals who were involved in activities other than lawful activities. There were narcotics, there were firearms taken out of some of the barbershops. Mm-hmm. In addition, if you may recall, there was a barbershop in East Orange County where we made over 23 arrests associated with individuals who were trafficking in narcotics, trafficking in firearms, involved in homicides, and they were simply using the barbershop as a front. In all honesty, I think you have to bring some balance to the discussion here.
Well, and I think that it's noteworthy that earlier this year, the State Department of Business and Professional Regulation settled a lawsuit that was brought against them. Your department has a mediation deadline coming up at the end of this month.
That's correct.
Why not go ahead and settle?
Well, because I don't believe that we did anything wrong. The Department of Business and Professional Regulation, it was their operation that was well within their purview to settle. They wanted to deal with it because of some issues that their personnel had done in the process. Mm-hmm. I believe my deputies were well within their rights. What they were doing was certainly unlawful. You know, there's been no question about that. However, we could have used some better tactics. I've gone on the record stating that it was not about any type of racial profiling or any of that. In fact, the overwhelming majority of the barbershops that were involved in that circumstance were not barbershops that can be characterized as being minority-owned or what have you. I stand here as an African-American, and I would not have anything to do with going in and impartially or improperly enforcing the law just because of someone's race or ethnicity.
Briefly, earlier that year in February, Tory Breedlove, an auto theft suspect, was cornered in an apartment complex, and officers felt their lives were in jeopardy when he tried to move that car out of that parking lot. But they fired more than 100 times. Some residents in apartments had bullets coming into their doorways and into their walls. Was that the proper way to handle that situation, and have you since instructed deputies to handle it differently?
Well, that has been before a jury of our peers. The grand jury has looked at that, cleared the law enforcement officers involved in that circumstance. That has been reviewed by the Florida Department of Law Enforcement. It has been reviewed by others. We've done our own internal review, and we've made some adjustments with our policies and training as it relates to that. We still have a pending lawsuit that the courts will determine in very near future. But Greg, I feel like you're just focusing on the negative here. Right? In fairness to the job that we've done as sheriff, there's been a lot of good work done by the men and women of the Orange County Sheriff's Office. For example, we have operated within budget. We returned $5.3 million to the taxpayers that was used to offset the budget reductions and avoid layoffs. The top five law enforcement agencies or sheriff's offices in the state have all had layoffs. The Orange County Sheriff's Office has not had layoffs during that period of time because of good management.
And I think as we wrap up here, I think it's noteworthy also that you had a larger budget coming in from Kevin Barry, your predecessor, and it's actually 1% less this year than it was 4 years ago. So you have done the same or better job.
That's correct.
With less in the way the crime rate has gone down. And we're going to talk to your opponent about that, Republican John Tegg, coming up after this quick commercial break. Thanks, Jerry.
Okay.